jumped in on us.
Suzuki's gonna bring me my belt. He can put it in the middle of the cage and give it to me, or I can take it the hard way.
And straight away, Askren goes for the takedown and punches to the head. It's all over in a minute and a half.
The new champion, Ben Askren,
slams him down. Boom, shakalaka.
You know, the one thing that real martial arts taught us is that it ain't about being the bully. It's about not getting beat up.
The last bounce in Ben Askren's studded career.
Thank you to my kids and my wife. I freaking love you guys. I can't wait to get home.
There you have it, Ben Askren!
That's Nikolai Aleksakin.
Touch.
Yes. That's Ben Askren.
Touch. You ready? You ready? Ready, go!
This fight brought to you by Patron Fuel for everyone. Askren in the black trunks. Aleksakin in the red. Big start from Askren as he goes chasing the Russian around the cage.
Ben Askren believes all he has to do is grab a hold of Aleksakin and the match is gonna be over. So you can see how he approaches that entry. He parries the hands, he tries to get close, clinch onto him. Threatening the takedown, it's just relentless, Steve. He's just constantly coming for you.
And he smiles at you as well, which is very disconcerting.
Nice little jab by Aleksakin. No, that's it. Nice little take, beautifully, as he transitioned up from the single leg to spotty lock.
Just
now Aleksakin's on the ground.
You can see how strong Aleksakin is. What a torso he has.
Yeah, but strength don't matter very much when you've got a grappler that is as good and as strong. You just can't hold on to him the way that most people do, like Rich was saying earlier. The way that he's going for that crucifix. He loves this position where he pins the arms down and then just punishes his opponent with the grounded pound.
Counterintuitive, isn't it? When you look at the two torsos, you think that Aleksakin would be the stronger man when they get to grips with each other, but it's all about cleverness, experience.
Aleksakin looks like he's wearing a Batman suit, but that's actually his body. That's kind of freaky. He is huge looking right now. Ben is just having his way. You could see that Aleksakin tried to throw him off, but just that center of gravity and that balance that Askren has, he's able to maintain that top position.
Elbows from Askren. There's blood on Aleksakin's shoulder that's come from somewhere on his face, I imagine.
There might be a small cut on the bridge of Askren's nose right there.
Yeah, I think it is Askren. I don't see anything on Aleksakin.
There's that crucifix position.
And the elbow and the fist attack Ben Askren's nose.
You can see the way that Aleksakin is scrambling. He's trying to use power and strength to get out of these positions. You gotta have superb technique to get out of, you know, Askren's side mount. You can't use power like that because this is 5 rounds, Steve. You know, 25 minutes of fighting. You've got to maintain and conserve your energy.
When you are in a cage with very technical fighters, technically gifted fighters like Askren, like, say, Shinya Aoki, you often wonder, well, what will happen if they just get hit clean in the face by a strong man? Well, that's what Aleksakin could do today. And if he has cut Askren, I wonder how that will perhaps change the course of this fight. Still can't exactly detect the source of that blood.
That
you
is
can
the
see some.
Beautiful thing of mixed martial arts, Steve, is that everybody's got a shot.
Mm.
Everybody has that one punch, that one kick that can change history. And Aleksakin has that shot here tonight. He has that golden opportunity. What is he gonna do with it? Is he just gonna succumb? Is he gonna give up? I don't think that's in him. I don't think that's part of his heart. But just when you have the skill level of Ben Askren, it's so tough to manage.
Just seen a minute and a half of Ben Askren just grinding on his opponent there with his forearms, pressing the head into the canvas, doing all he can to irritate and hurt his opponent so that he can move one step at a time to the final moment where he could win the fight.
Aleksakin is a world champion combat sambo, but not that much of sambo is spent with them on their back. They're not learning to play with their guards. They're not, you know, threatening from those submissions the way the Brazilian jiu-jitsu fighters are. And they're used to a different type. They have the leg locks, they have that capability, but I just don't know if he's had the experience of being on his back with a grappler the capability of Ben Askren.
Still uncertain where the blood's coming from, but my best guess now is that it's Alex Sarkin's nose.
Yeah, that is such a helpless position to be in when he has you crucifixed. Ben Askren is world renowned for putting people in that, and not there, even his own teammates can't get out of it, and he's not going 100%. When Ben Askren is full on 100%, man, nothing but trouble. Nothing but trouble. Oh, big elbow landed by Askren from that side mount.
A lot of elbows and forearms, Mitch. That's where he's doing most of his work.
Alex Sarkin got back up to his knees. He transitioned out of it, but Ben Askren is all over him.
He takes a knee to the head, and I think he's cut just to the side of the eye as well there. Certainly his head has taken some abuse, mainly from Askren's forearms and elbows. But throwing the odd knee, it's only going to worsen the trouble, isn't it?
Yeah, there's that takedown. He's transitioning. See how he just scoots around to the side like that? And then just the takedown is inevitable once Ben Askren gets a hold of you. Rich, how do you have it so far in the first round?
I think the fans sitting at home know who you can score this for. This is definitely a round that's all Ben Askren. Earned the takedown at the beginning of the round there. Controlled the ground the whole time. And while on the ground, just the ground and pound started adding up. He scored some damage in the round as well. Ben Askren round. Fight stopped now, definitely.
A little bit of damage, a little bit of aggression shown by Alex Sarkin. I wonder if he can turn this around. What does he have to do?
He can turn it around. He's got four more rounds to do that. But when you have a guy like Ben Askren on top of you for an entire round like that, you just have to imagine how tired Alex Sarkin is. You made a comment earlier about him exploding a whole bunch to try to get Ben off of him, and he's just using a lot of muscle. So I would imagine that Alex Sarkin is just going to be more tired in this round. Let's see.
Update on the facial injuries. Looks to me as if Ben Askren has a little nick on the inside of his right eye towards the nose there. And I do think that Alex Sarkin is bleeding from the nose, so.
Nice little uppercut there thrown by Alex Sarkin. But he's got to be tentative to really let those strikes go when he knows the takedown. Oh, Ben Askren.
You don't usually see that, and he gives a little smile.
A spinning back kick from Ben Askren. I like to see him changing it up. When you have the wrestling pedigree of Ben Askren, you can throw shots like that. I don't know how many of those we're going to see, but it's good to see the creativity of him.
Given that it didn't work out too well, maybe he'll hold off for a little while. Oh, spinning back elbow, though. I think that connected.
See, it's okay for him to do that because he's not scared of the repercussions of it. He might get caught with a punch or a kick, but usually strikers are tentative, like Alex Sarkin is, slightly, when they know the takedown is coming. Not very many people have the capabilities to take down Ben Askren.
Just in that standing exchange there, the way he bent his knees, stuck his backside out, just to create the balance that he needs to then make the sweep and bring Alex Sarkin to the ground. Years of experience and learning what he can do with his body to overcome potentially a stronger man.
And every single takedown, Ben Askren is ending up in side control where he can utilize that crucifix to just slow the fight down. And Alex Sarkin is the one expending all the energy here. Ben's relaxed, he's calm. He's probably been in this position for 10,000 hours. And he just knows how to conserve his energy, how to wait it out, and whatever moves that Alex Sarkin's making, he knows the counter. Oh, slides into mount, takes the back of Alex Sarkin. That right arm's really the only thing stopping him from taking the back fully. Good by Alex Sarkin to end up on top, but I don't know if this is gonna last too long.
Well, the crowd saw that and certainly appreciated it.
See, I don't know if you caught that, Steve, but the flexibility of Askren's shoulders to maintain that hold on his leg while fully extended is really something rare. He's able to move so well. You can see the mouth wide open on Alex Sarkin, and it's only halfway through the second round.
Alex Sarkin is supposed to have the striking ability to make this a match, but Ben actually shows quite a bit of Good timing with that left jab. They both teetered on the brink for a comical second or two there before both coming down.
Nice punch there. But with every minute that goes by, he's losing a little bit of that power.
Yeah, there's the punch and the knee.
Yeah.
Were just a little bit, well, they lacked sharpness, didn't they? This is a five-round contest, remember, potentially 25 minutes. This is no time for Alex Sarkin to be losing the crispness of his work, not this early in the fight.
And now Ben is just beating him up. He easily locks that arm into position, and now he can just punch. Unopposed shots land on the face of Nikolai Alex Sarkin.
And it's just open, isn't it? That crucifix position that you were talking about just exposes the face to every kind of punch that Askren wants to throw.
See, in every single escape Alex Sarkin is doing is a big explosion of energy. He's just throwing Askren. And Askren just floats around, kind of just waiting like a surfer riding the wave.
Guillotine attempt.
He's doing the right thing by putting his head on the mat and kind of alleviating some pressure. So Ben is forced to transition out of it and go to the back now. As we're approaching the final 30, Ben is just all over him.
So quick to stay in a position where he can take the back, the technical ground kick. And it's all Alex Sarkin can do to grab that leg so that it doesn't happen again, but it will unless he's very careful.
So tough, just because I don't know if you guys are catching this, but the way that he just pops his legs out every time Alex Sarkin tries to grab onto something, you know, Ben has an answer for it. He's just one step ahead every single time. Really tough round.
And 10 minutes in the book. And there you can see the cut is actually on the bridge of the nose, which I think is what you said, to be fair, in the very first instance.
Look at that nice takedown there where Ben was able to land up on top and just more of the same. The first round was the same as the second. Rich, what do you think so far?
Ben's just increasing his lead. Once again, he earns a takedown. Neither fighter came out very aggressive this round, but he earned the takedown at the beginning of the round. Controlled on the bottom controlled from the top position and just still started mounting up even more damage on the ground there. No question in my mind that 10 minutes into the fight, Ben is winning this fight. The interesting thing is that Alex Sarkin, you had made a comment, Mitch, that he was breathing very heavy, and you can see that his arms are looking heavy. It takes a lot of oxygen to supply those muscles, and his chances of winning this fight are just becoming even more thin because he's not going to have the pop on his punches that he needs to stop Askren later in the round. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, not a good sign if he's tiring and if he's getting a little bit ponderous just two-fifths of the way through a potentially 25-minute fight.
Yeah, Alex Sarkin, he's got a heart of a warrior. He knows what's at stake. He's still got a little crispness to his jab there. You know, I know he knows what this opportunity is.
Oh, right hand from Ben with a left, and then he gets answered with a nice right hand as well. And again, Ben smiles at his opponent. Left, right, left. And Ben Askren's gum shield has come out. He's still smiling. Yuji Shimada stops the fight. Get that gum shield in quickly, Yuji. We don't want to miss this action.
That's exactly what Alex Sarkin needs. He needs to take advantage of this slight edge he might have in striking because the ground game is not going his way.
This is what I was talking about. What happens to a very technical fighter when he gets punched in the face? Alex Sarkin may be able to supply us with the answer because he's getting through consistently. And that was an uppercut. And Ben Askren seems to have a fairly decent chin.
That's 1 minute right now of Alex Sarkin landing some nice strikes. That uppercut was good. Snapped the head back of Ben. That's going to give him a little bit of confidence. It's going to boost his energy. Hopefully he's got enough left in the gas tank to capitalize on this.
Plenty of clean punches landed by the Russian in this third round.
Look, Steve, he's getting a bounce back in his step. He's moving. That little bit of success he's having is recharging him.
The attempted spinning back fist from Askren, again, a little bit short of the mark.
But I did not expect Alex Sakin to come out like that.
From Alex Sakin, it was a left right, and it was the right hand that really did the damage. And a left hand again from the Russian. And don't forget, there's already damage to Askren's nose, and he had better go for the takedown.
Oh, yeah. I was wondering how long Ben was going to wait on that. He does not want to be on the extreme end of some of these big punches. And again, Alex Sakin's got a chance.
Crowd are loving this.
He can't let the moment overwhelm him because Ben's going to jump on him any chance he gets. Oh, no. Oh, he's kind of fell to the ground.
That was just fatigue, wasn't it? It's taken it out of him. The first half of this round, Alex Sakin was in charge as they were standing up, but it's clearly taken it out of him. And this is where Ben Askren lives, and lives very comfortably, thank you.
Yeah, Steve, he just sliced through Alex Sakin's guard like a hot knife through butter. He just floated right in to side control, and now we're right back to where most of the fight has taken place. And this is where Ben Askren is just shining. Alex Sakin knows he had a little bit of success. He's got to get back up to his feet.
Alex Sakin's corner men shouting out loud instructions that I can't translate for you.
And look, I mean, just the blanket, like that Ben Askren gets on top of you and just pounds on you. And I mean, you guys back home, if you guys are watching this as young fighters, watch what Ben Askren is doing. Watch how he transitions from move to move. This is world-class wrestling, truly at its finest.
Yuji Shimada calls for action again. Oh. Elbows just thudding down on the Russian's face. Minute and a quarter left in this third round. Remember, this is not the last round. This is a super fight, so we go five-minute rounds.
Yeah, while to finish.
The fight scored in its entirety, not round by round.
These little shots are accumulating, and especially when there's the forearms and those elbows, those are hurt. That's a short distance, so if you're gonna drop something, it's a forearm, because you can put your entire body weight behind it and really just start smashing the side of somebody's face in. And you can see Ben, he doesn't really get overexcited about it. He lands three or four clean shots and then goes back, establishes position again, and then drops some more.
Elbow to the temple there, and a knee coming into the side of the head. Alex Sakin taking some punishment. 17 seconds left in this third round. The championship rounds are beckoning.
Steve, this fight has been so disproportionate in the favor of Ben Askren, but the heart is not going out of Alex Sakin.
No,
he continues
indeed.
To battle and fight for every single inch that he can. Tremendous round again, but I mean, we saw a little bit of excitement there from Alex Sakin as he lands some big strikes. Here comes that up. Boom, there's that right hand. Ben's like, oh, that, yeah, you got me. That was a good one. There's some nice strikes. There's that uppercut. Rich, how did you see that round with the flurry that Alex Sakin had?
Well, I'll tell you, you know, I made a comment about Alex Sakin not having snap on his punches, and he has to come out at the beginning of the round and make a liar out of me on this whole thing. In this particular portion of the fight, Alex Sakin kind of closed the distance a little bit on Ben's lead. This, for him, was all about the striking superiority. Ben took him down with about 240 left in the round, and he had control the whole time. But I think that that Alex Sakin did more damage on the feet particularly, and so he won the striking superiority, or he's ahead on the striking superiority in this fight. Not enough to actually give him the win at this point, obviously, but he's at least closing the distance on the lead. Let's see what he can do in this round.
Yeah, much of it will depend on how long he can keep the fight in this standing position. Every round, every fight, every round starts with the two fighters standing up. How long can he maintain the status quo?
That's a very good point, Steve. Every fight starts in favor of the striker. What happens in the middle is completely up to the two gentlemen in the cage right now. Oh, nice step off. That was pretty. The footwork of Alex Sakin to still have the snap in his footwork. That he's still got something in there.
And he's still got those punches. Oh, and that again, Ben Askren is caught flush with a very firm punch.
See, sometimes when you get hit and you smile, it actually kind of hurts. You're not just, you know, taking it, but it's a psychological ploy. But you usually know that it stings a little bit.
Using the word firm, because there's not any crispness or sharpness there, is there? But they're heavy.
Oh, good footwork. That's nice as Ben Askren shoots in. You just saw a nice little step off.
Just got his hand up there, Ben Askren, to just take some of the bite out of that kick to the head.
Real good lateral movement showed by Nikolai Aleksakin.
Right hand lands high up on Ben's head.
See, now we're in the championship round, so this is when the heart of the fire is so important. Get away from it.
That's right. Get back in the stand-up. That's the advice that he should be taking. That's where he's had his success. You saw how Rich scored the striking superiority so heavily in his favor. Of course, that's not all there is to this fight, not by a long way. But this is where he can take advantage.
See, the stance of Ben Askren is almost open-handed, like he's looking to grab on to Aleksakin on almost every single exchange. That open stance leaves him so vulnerable to these punches landed by Nikolai Aleksakin. Nice takedown by Ben Askren. And now we are right back.
Yeah, with 2:40 left in this round, it's hard to see how Aleksakin can get back onto his feet, not with Ben Askren on top, unless Yuji Shimada suddenly calls for action and stands him up. But again, with Ben Askren on top, I can't see that.
Yeah, he's just so smart and strategic about his ground and pound. He knows what he can get away with, and there's no stand-ups because he is able to control Aleksakin, but then he lands some strikes, control. Oh, nice bridge! Nice little hip bump sweep by Nikolai Aleksakin. Again, he's trying to stand up right now.
Don't blame him. It's not often that happens to Ben Askren.
That's huge to be swept like that and ended up in the guard. We rarely see Ben Askren on his back in the guard, but look how active he is, just punching from the guard position.
He's actually finding more offense than Aleksakin is from his back, which is quite special, actually.
Yeah, but those punches really aren't going to do a lot of damage.
Kick as well.
That's it. Step away, Nikolai. Yeah. Let him get back up.
I don't think he's going to go down there again.
He's threatening it. He's not scared.
Ben won't be in any hurry to get up, of course. If he can invite him back down again, he will.
See,
Ben actually goes for his legs while he's on his back.
Yeah, but he should rest a little bit. He should kind of use this time to regain some of that energy, because he knows that he can get back up. Yuji immediately calls for action as they meet in the center of the cage.
103 left in this fourth round, this super fight of 5 5-minute rounds. The welterweight title is not at stake here.
Ben's landing some good front kicks there, and that spinning back kick kind of landed on the side there of Askren. Not enough to do damage. He's got 30 seconds left here. Ben Askren, the spinning back fist. Oh, hunting for the takedown.
Slipped out of that.
That's what Aleksakin needs. He needs to have these small little wins to build up his confidence.
Caught the leg and sent in the right hand. Just clipped Ben around the chin.
This has been four tough rounds of Ben Askren on top, but there has been aspects where Nikolai Aleksakin has been able to have some success, just like that. It'll be interesting to see if this striking that, you know, Nikolai Aleksakin has. Let's just jump right to Rich Franklin. How do you have it so far as we enter the fifth and final round?
Honestly, I think Aleksakin's actually closed the distance up a bit more in that round. Striking superiority once again. He was able to hit a reversal in that round and put Ben on his back, get back to his feet and all that kind of stuff. I think he did a little bit of damage in that fight as well. Ultimately, Ben lands the takedown, so he's running that category. And Ben himself hit an up, you know, a nice up kick, a couple jabs, a couple kicks to Alex Sakin to the mid body and all that kind of stuff. But I still have Ben ahead on the scorecards, and I think significantly what's keeping the lead here for him is that he's inflicted more damage to Alex Sakin than Alex Sakin has done to him. So at this point in time, if the fight was stopped, decision would go to Ben, in my opinion.
Is that gap too big, Rich, for the fight to be turned around in this final round?
Absolutely not. Listen, Ben, Ben is standing in front of him and not throwing a lot and still getting hit with some punches and stuff like that. And if these punches can do enough damage, there's enough time in this fifth round to change the lead here and steal this fight.
So essentially, it seems like it's all about how long Alex Sakin can keep this fight on its feet and dominate the way he has done in the striking compartment of this contest. Ooh, there's nice. The right hand, the first sign that he can do this.
Nice crisp combination shown by Alex Sakin. He knows that this is his last chance to do it. But man, when Ben gets a hold of you, sucks in, especially when his hands lock, Steve, you are in a world of trouble. If Ben can get both arms around you, lock his hands, he will suck you to the ground.
Oh, busy, busy elbows and hammer blows from Ben Askren. In the fifth round, there's no let up to the pace with those short little sharp punches.
Yeah, that's just enough. Nice little turnaround, but see how Ben just transitions, gets that hit. But Alex Sakin stands up and lets it go.
Got up very well. Tremendous strength of the legs to have done that so quickly and then let the punches go.
See, Alex Sakin is just not throwing one shot. All of his punches come in bunches. He is putting these strikes together, and it lands on Askren, and then another one follows it up, and that's where he's seeing success. He's got to put more combinations together.
He's got to be careful, Ben, as he dove in with that punch. He missed and got caught coming in. He doesn't want to add his own momentum to the power of Alex Sakin's punches.
Ben's going back to his bread and butter. See how he controls the arm? Yeah. Alex Sakin trying to push off. Ben just grabbed that arm to keep him tight.
3.25 minutes left. Left, right from the Russian. He needs more of that.
Alex Sakin's got more in him. Look at that. The spinning back fist to the takedown attempt. I like that move. I like the transition. He distracts you, gets you moving back, and then goes right in for the legs. Uh-oh, knees to the head.
Not just the head, but to the face.
You see how he's controlling the leg? Oh man, that's, I mean, just the grappling that, you know, Ben is showing in this fight is so unique. Drag sacrifice. Now he just drags him to the mat, throws Alex Sakin on top of him, and then just rolls over to the side.
Inside the final 2.5 minutes of this 25-minute fight. Ben has Nikolai's back.
See how he's trapping that arm?
Is he looking for the...
See how he's controlling that left arm of Alex Sakin, how he grapevines underneath, controls the wrist, kind of opens up that side. It gives him the possibility of a submission. If he lets go, left hand's there for the choke. Yep, just like that. Ben Askren proving he is quite possibly the very best welterweight in the world with this grappling clinic that he is putting on.
With the punches that we've seen him take in this fight, Mitch, it is actually hard to see who could finish him in that way. We've seen Sapo, land some big punches in there, somewhat truncated fight, but he has demonstrated in this fight a pretty strong chin, hasn't he? A durability that perhaps we didn't know about before.
Steve, he is an Olympic level wrestler, one of the best grapplers in all of the world. His neck has got to be so strong from balancing on his head for, you know, 20, 30 years, probably close to like 27 years he's been doing this. His neck is going to be so conditioned and tough that he can handle those punches, because that's what controls the knockout, is when your head gets snaps back and it moves so quickly that you get knocked out. When you have a neck, the strength of, you know, Askren, it's a lot easier to take those punches.
Final 30 seconds inside that last half minute. Ben Askren looks to be on top, although one important aspect of the fight, Nikolai Aleksakin has certainly dominated when they've been standing up and trading punches. So kudos to him for that. But it's about the bigger picture of who's controlled this contest. And once again, it seems to be Ben Askren to the fore. Although again, he gets clipped in these final moments. Too little, too late, you feel for the Russian. It's all over. 25 minutes of high, high level mixed martial arts. Not a comprehensive win for Ben Askren by any means, but he looks to have done enough. Rich Franklin, would you agree with that?
Yeah, I believe this is Ben's fight at this point in time. Look, Aleksakin at the beginning of each round was closing the distance each time with some good strikes and stuff like that, but he just couldn't stop the takedown. Ben was able to control, ground control, and just continue to mount damage. So, in my opinion, unanimous decision, Ben Askren for the win.
So that's Rich Franklin's decision. We await the decision of the official judges. Yuji Shimada has both fighters in his grips, and we'll hear what the judges have to say in this super fight here in Manila.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. Ben Funky Askren!
Ben Askren is your winner. He's been very unlucky, Mitch, in terms of his opponents not making weight. It'd be nice to see him defend his belt against Sue, but how good is this fighter?
Oh, man, he is the best welterweight in the world. And it is just an amazing to watch him every time he steps into the cage. I'm a fan. I can't wait for his next fight.
All right, me neither. It's been a great night here in the Mall of Asia Arena. It's been a great night for Team Lakai fighters, a great fight for Filipino fighters in general.